game and I'm still the same and I never change just to get a deal, but I'm ballin', ballin'. I came from nothing to something like it's nothing, yeah, you know I done it, that is no discussion, bitch.
Hey, what's up guys, Henry the Blazion here, and yesterday we ended up getting some new throwback elite cards. Among those cards was this Diamond Arvydas Sabonis 95 overall. Now I really didn't find the throwback elites too hype other than this card, which basically carried the throwbacks. There was the Pink Diamond Phil Chenier or something. I've never heard of that man before. And then there was also the Amethyst Karan Butler. If you guys want me to do gameplays on this cards, let me know down in the comment section below. But Sabonis, this man is always a popular card in 2K every year. And when we dive into these stats, man, you're going to see why. So let's go right into it before we hop into a game. And as you guys can see, man, 97 offensive overall, 95 defense, 7'3". That is right, guys. Size matters this year. So he's definitely going to be an even bigger impact because of that. 279 pounds. Taking a look at the stats here, 74 driving layup, not surprised he's a big man. Still a bit underwhelming. His post game is nice though, 90 post fadeaway, 95 post hook, and post control. Depending on those animations, he's gonna be OP because again, he's 7'3". 90 draw fouls, really nice. There is a shoe put on him. I bought this card and it came with shoes and some badges that were put on him, so forgive me if I don't know what the original stats was. I'm pretty sure the contested mid-range originally was a 95 with that open. Correct me if I'm wrong though. He doesn't have an off dribble though. He's got an open three of a 92 though. Open 92, 90 contested. If you give this man deep range dead eye, if he doesn't already have it, he's gonna be such a threat, man. 93 free throw as well. The dunking is there, but it's not something I really trust when it comes to a Sabonis card. He doesn't really have the ball control, but his passing is elite. And you're gonna see how elite it really is later on when we look at the badges. 90 block, 92 shot contest, 75 steals, and actually not bad for a big man. The rebounding is definitely there. He's got 70 speed and acceleration, 75 vertical. The more you look at this card, the more you kind of feel like he's a better version of Amethyst Porzingis. He's got 95 strength, which is a big up over Porzingis. Again, he is a thick man, so he's gonna be really dogging people in the post. 95 stamina, decent hustle. That 37 lateral quickness definitely hurts, but keep in mind, Jokic used to have 37 lateral quickness and he was only 7 feet tall. This man, at least he's covering more surface area. But the defense, it's all in the 90s for the most part, so he's actually looking really good top to bottom. Like, the 95 defensive overall actually makes sense. Now, what is actually really nice about this card though is going to be the badges. He's only got one Hall of Fame badge, but it's a really nice one to have on a big man. Hall of Fame Dimer. This man, he's basically the taller, better version of Jokic, actually, the more I think of it. And he's also got some good badges to back it up. Now, he does have 20 gold badges here. I'm not really sure which ones were added on, so I'm just gonna go ahead and I'm gonna skim through them in case I say some of them were wrong. I don't want to misguide you guys on information, but I'm gonna show you guys what badges that he has before we go into a game, just in case it affects his overall performance in game. So you can see they didn't give him limitless range or deep range dead eye, I don't think, so we won't really be shooting shots from half court with my boy Sabonis. But he's got good passive badges as well, and I am ready to get to work with this genius, guys. So without further ado, man, let's hop into a game and let's see what Diamond Arvydas Sabonis has in store for us. Let's get into it. And our matchup for today is looking like Pink Diamond Magic Johnson, Brandon Roy, Havlicek, Kuzma, and Hakeem. Should be a pretty good matchup. Sabonis, it's time to see what you got, man. Here we go, boys. Jump ball. Sabonis, 7'3", winning the jump ball to start the game. Get my man inside the paint right away. Going up and a nice dunk to get the game started. Watch this finesse. Come here, and push back. Oh, it's an easy pull. Give it to me. Green, being that jumper is looking nice. 4 quick points for Sabonis. What would be crazy is if this Sabonis had 3-point plays. Turns out he doesn't have 3-point plays. Oh, he's going to be the point guard in this possession. Okay, he's got that dimer anyways. Catch and shoot, baby. Green bean. Yeah, Kuzma, you're not hitting that. Sabonis, I know you're getting that rebound again. There we go. Now let's push it. Oh, I see my boy Barry in transition. Got to feed him. That card is just too nice. Go to Magic. One thing I will say about Sabonis is he doesn't really look as 7'3" as someone like Porzingis does. I guess Hakeem is 7 feet tall, so it makes sense. Okay, now you can definitely see it in the post. Let's see what that fadeaway looks like. Yeah, you're not defending that. Easy money. Nice steal there by Sabonis to Magic. Straight to Sabonis. One more pass to the corner. Easy pull and nice assist for Sabonis again. My man's got 6-2-2 in the first quarter here. Alright guys, started the second half. He started to play a lot of pick and roll offense, which I am ready for. He's gonna call another screen. Yeah, it's not gonna work this time. Roy, you can take it all the way to get this quarter started. God damn, that Zach LaVine was getting back on defense. Let's get a pick and fade going here with my boy. Hit that screen. Let's get the second half started. Oh, he's too open. Catch and shoot. Give it to me. Nice bucket. That jumper is so easy, man. Get right in the post. There's no way we're not taking advantage of that. Come here, Sabonis. Easy pass aside. Come here. Yeah, little man. That's an easy fadeaway, and that's an easy bucket. Give it to me. Thank you. This guy's really still running Melo at center. The disrespect. Yo, this guy is a reach god. Go there. Straight to Melo. Come here. Come here, little man. Easy post hook and an easy bucket. We are attacking that. Looks like his takeover is sharpshooting glass cleaner. Clamp up. Clamp up. Good defense. Good defense. Good defense. There we go. Let's push it. Straight to Worthy. Worthy to Sabonis. All the way. Let's see. Where are we going? He's reaching a ton, so just be ready to be open. Oh, Worthy's open. That's an easy three. Where's your defense, my guy? I'll take those. Give me that. That's a steal. Thank you. All right, let's get the second half started. Who are we going to? Oh, Sabonis, I see you. Catch. Slash. Oh, Kuzma's open. Catch and shoot, baby. Give me that assist. There we go. I'm going to try to get a triple-double with this card. And just when I say that, guys, our opponent has left the match. Now, one game is obviously not going to be enough with this Sabonis. So let's go ahead and let's hop into another one. And for our second matchup, it's looking like Magic Johnson, Kuzma at the 2, okay, Chris Mullin, Maurice Lucas, and Ardis Gilmore. Let's see how this game goes. Ardis Gilmore definitely has more size and thickness to him. Pause, but let's hoop. Ah, yeah, yeah, he's got the courts that are blending in with my jerseys. All good, though. I tried to jump, and Sabonis didn't even want to jump. I guess we want to give this guy a chance. I'm not gonna lie, as much as I get to blend with the court, I am not a fan of that because I can't see where my players are. We'll go into a pick and fade, hit that. Oh, he's open. Catch and shoot to start the game. Bang. Not too high of a scoring game to start. Oh, he's reaching a ton. Sabonis, keep going all the way. Inside and easy post hook. One thing I will say about this Sabonis over a card like Porzingis is he's got that strength in the post and it's insane. Porzingis has those fadeaways where you really got to be out there to guard though. All right, let's protect the paint here, guys. Come on. All right, Sabonis, you want to play point guard? We're going to have you play point guard. Give me that double screen. We're pushing around it. We're attacking. Oh, he's open. Easy dimer pass and an easy bucket. That's actually a pretty good play if he was faster with the ball. But other than that, it's pretty easy to read. All right, let's see. Where are we going here? Ooh, I see Sabonis trailing. One more swing. Easy bucket there. That's a nice assist. Ooh, that was an easy moving shot. I'll take that. Come here. Good defense. Give me that. Thank you. I'll take that. Going to Rick Barry. White boy's got hops. Show him. Oh, wow. He really wanted to dunk on Magic, but instead, we're going to get some free throws here. Now, not to be racist. I don't even really think this is racist. I think it's an actual benefit, but they've given all the white guys some good jumpers this year. Bob Pettit got that base 11. Kirilenko got that base 11. Sabonis' jumper is beautiful. Porzingis' jumper is beautiful. Rick Barry's jumper this year is now beautiful. They're really blessing, and I'm liking it. It's making them a lot more usable. That just sounds bad. I'm going to stop talking before I keep sounding like a racist here. Sabonis, go all the way to the rim and give me a dunk. Okay, thanks. Pick and pop again for the win. His pick and fade really is annoying. We're going behind the back. Oh, he's hitting it. It's too late. We're open now. Catch and shoot. Give it to me. Bang. Good defense there, Rick Barry. You already know who I'm going to. Sabonis. Oh, is that from three? Please be from three. Ah, it's only a two. That's tough. I want Sabonis to get open. Let's go to Rick Barry. Let's go to my man Sabonis. Oh, we're going all the way to the rim. Easy layups. Thank you. On a real note, though, this Sabonis with limitless range would honestly be really annoying. We're going straight to the pick and fade. He's got the sharpshooter takeover. Oh, no, that's deep. Oh, green bean! Yo, does it give you that automatic limitless? He's going to be out of there on that. That is crazy. We really hit that shot with him. Back to Sabonis. Step back from three, baby. Green! Yo, 20 points in the first quarter for Sabonis. We are murdering this man. Yeah, he's out of here. Yup, he's already out of here. That was violation, man. Yup, and just like that, our opponent has left the match. Now, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to try for one more game, and we're going to see how it goes. And then after that, guys, we're going to go ahead and we're going to call it. All right, on to game number three. Hopefully, our final game. Oh, that's a good matchup. A defensive center in Nurkic, Bob Pettit, Durant, Bradley Beal, and Penny Hardaway. Not looking so intimidating, but that Nurkic is probably his best card. Let's see what the Sabonis can do. Alrighty, let's get this game started. Sabonis, you already know what the deal is. Pick and fade to start the game from high. Hit that screen. Thank you. Catch and shoot. Oh my goodness, no chance. That's going down. Yo, this card low-key has limitless range. Where are we going? Oh, Worthy's already running. But I'm going out to Sabonis. Pump fake. I want to get a dime. Easy pass. Easy assist. Green bean. Hopefully we can blow this guy out because what I want to do is just get this game over with. Oh, we already got Sabonis in here. Get this Penny out my way. Look at the strength. Come here, little one. Let's see. Let's go to Rick Barry there. Slash through. We're hopping. Sabonis is open. Catch and shoot. Green bean. Yo, the fact that he was spreading the floor like that, I like it. Get that rebound. Thank you. Let's go. Now let's push it. Let's go to Magic. Sabonis, run with me. Now go all the way, please. He actually went for the layup and finished it. Usually he's getting blocked on that, but nice layup. Let's go to Roy. Roy to Magic. Oh, he's already reaching like that. Sabonis, keep running, please. There we go. Now get in the post. Get an assist to someone. Catch and shoot. Green. Green. Yeah, that Hall of Fame dimer. It's going to be a threat in the post, man. I see Sabonis open. Catch and shoot. Is it going down? Oh, my goodness. That wasn't contested. I'm going to swing those two people on me. Oh, Roy's open. One more pass. We're open. That's in your face. Bradley Beal's not going to contest me. Clamp up, clamp up, clamp up. I'm reaching on this. I'm reaching on this soon. Get out of my way. Give me that. There we go. Rick Barry defense. Oh, that's an alley for you, Worthy, if you keep running. There we go. Why'd you go for the layup, man? That's so not hype. Be ready for it. Good closeout, Worthy. Nice rebound, Rick Barry. And now we run it. Let's go to my boy. To my boy right back. Catch and shoot. I love this, Rick Barry. Show me why. Show me why. What you gonna do? What you gonna do? What you gonna do, Lillard? Get out of my house, man. That's Sabonis' house, Roy. Let him know how you dunk in this game. Beautiful. Oh my god, what kind of defense is that? I'm pulling that in your face. There's nobody on me if you're using a point guard to guard a 7-3 center. Ooh, Magic got the takeover dimer. That means we gotta pick and pay and hit that screen real quick. Thank you. Look, no contest. It doesn't matter how tall you are, Lillard. I'm gonna hit those every time. Sabonis, be a nice little point guard here. Ooh, I see someone open in the corner. What are you doing on defense, my guy? Easy three once again. Yeah, that Hall of Fame dimer on him is going to be so useful on fast breaks in different scenarios. Good defense. That's not going down. Get that rebound. Thank you, guys. Let's push it. Where are we going? Oh, we're going to Sabonis, my dimer, of course, to Barry. Catch and shoot for three. Bang! All right, guys, start of the second half here. I'm honestly surprised this guy hasn't quit. The biggest reason I really want him to quit is more so this gameplay isn't too long. I'm also trying to go 12-0, so I really just don't want to have to wait through games because it's just a waste of time. But if you want me to hoop on you, then hoop on you is what you're going to get. Go all the way. Sabonis is open. Catch and shoot. I don't know how that's going to go in, but it looks looking like it will. All right, pick and fade here with my guy. Looks like he's just off-balling with Giannis. That works out for me, though, because if there's that switch there, catch and shoot with zero contest. I like those. I love those. 2:25 to go. We haven't really been scoring this quarter again. This guy's been reaching a ton. That's an easy catch and shoot. You were reaching way too much. Easy bucket there for Wade. Go here. Oh, Kuzma's open. Catch and shoot. That was a great pass. That's a great shot. Sabonis in the post. We're switching. Oh, that's going to be an easy post hook or a weird animation that's going to give us an easy layup. What was that? Where's my man Sabonis? Oh, I see him open. Catch and shoot from the mid-range. Easy bucket. Oh, he's getting a little tired. Hopefully, he can still continue to green some jumpers. I'm going to have to call some timeouts here. Well into the fourth quarter now, still with no bucket. Let's try to get a nice easy bucket here. Oh, we're switching. Oh, you're not even defending right. Easy fadeaway from my man's. Easy bucket. Thank you. I see Sabonis there. Ooh, that's an easy assist to Kobe. Catch and shoot, baby. Hall of Fame dimer in transition again, doing its thing. Go back to Sabonis, right in the post, and Julius is open, easy assist right there, give it to me, thank you. Let's go straight to Roy, straight to Magic, into a pick and fade with my man Sabonis, hit that screen, oh he's open, catch and shoot from three, that's gotta go down, thank you. He's really tired, so I feel like some shots are gonna miss, but it looks like he's just consistent. 45 seconds to go, can I get my boy Sabonis a double-double at least, catch and shoot, oh that's going down, that has to go down, he didn't contest that enough. Straight to Sabonis. Sabonis to Magic. Catch and shoot. Give me that final assist. Thank you, my guy. We got 10 assists. Now I'm going to try to get 40 points before this game ends. And as you guys can see, man, we go ahead and we win this game 74-57. Not really too much effort was put into this game. Sabonis was just dominant from start to finish. I'm really surprised, again, that this guy didn't quit. But yeah, let's go ahead. Let's check out the box score, man. And let's see how this Sabonis did. And as you guys can see, man, in 20 minutes, Sabonis brought the production. 38 points, 6 rebounds, 10 assists, a steal, a block, only one turnover. He shot 15 for 30 from the field, which although it is 50%, it's a bit on the lower end when it comes to a big man. The thing is, I was trying for a lot of driving layups and a bunch of dumb stuff. Just because I was already up 20 points, I started to kind of not care for the game and took a bunch of dumb shots. But when it came to the three-pointer, man, that shot was lights out regardless. There's times we had Lillard right on us, and I would take the shot. Now, my logic for that was I thought basically is that if I was a Porzingis card, with them being the same height and them playing very similarly, there was no way Damian Lillard was going to be able to contest the Porzingis, so I would just shoot that in his eye. Unless you're going to be jumping at this card, rarely is this card going to be getting heavily contested. It's most likely going to be a lightly contest every single time, even when your arm's up. So if I give this man deep range Jedi, limitless range, he is seriously going to be a problem. But overall, man, this card really came here and he really performed. I had a ton of fun with him. I really like that jumper, and I really like the fact fact that he's got really good post game on top of it, so that really helps with him being a threat all over the court. I do wish his takeover was the post takeover and sharpshooter, because that would just take it over the top. The glass cleaner takeover is not really something I've ever really cared for. It's nice to see where the rebound goes, but sometimes it doesn't even matter where it's going because people are either already there or they're not there. But yeah guys, this Sabonis, he is indeed a hooper. Now a lot of people were wondering, is he going to be worth the 220 to 30k he's going for? Yes and no. I mean, like, if you already have Porzingis, you don't really need to make that crazy upgrade for the extra 160k or whatever much it would be. You can be okay with Porzingis. The one thing from Porzingis to Sabonis again is he has that strength, and he has that serious strength again in the post, and I think he kind of has better defense when it comes to protecting the rim than Porzingis. Porzingis does look longer, but I feel like Sabonis definitely protects the rim a lot better than Porzingis. Him being that heavy again too, Shaq won't just bully him around like he would Porzingis. But yeah guys, if I had to say was a good price for this Sabonis, I'd probably say around 150k to 175k. If you land him for that price, I think overall this card is a W and will be a threat against almost any center. If he's able to low-key hold Shaq, being 279 pounds and having that 95 strength, it's going to be a big dub on both ends of the court. But yeah guys, this is going to be the end of the video. I hope you guys did enjoy the video, and if you did, don't forget to leave a like. And for you new viewers, you know you gotta hit that subscribe button and join the Blazer Nation. I want to thank you guys for watching. I hope you all have an awesome day and take care. Take it down.